siyum, Masecha Sota Yerushalmi, and also Tosefta Masecha Sota. It's a beautiful combination. You know, slowly, I think even us simple people that are learning Yerushalmi and walking around with the green art scroll Yerushalmi is making it a little bit more normal and popular. People still don't know what this green sefer is, but it's Yerushalmi, and it really gives a whole different understanding and depth. And Tosefta, every time we quote Yerushalmi, we get all excited. And especially this trip that we had with Kesaria, where Yerushalmi nonstop quotes Dayone Kesaria, and Rabbanan Kesaria, and Rabbi Avo from Kesaria, right? The real keva of Rabbi Avo, the student of Rabbi Yechanan. In any rate, so the end of Masecha Saita, I think, is something, hopefully a lesson that we can really take with us. And that is, Yerushalmi says, and it's based on the Mishnah, that as the generations get older, and so to speak, we go from one generation to the next, and low and low, and we get closer to Yemei Mashiach, it says that things go sour. The Mishnah says, and that they still have to point this out, the fruits doesn't taste the same, the vegetables don't taste the same, people are not the same, you can't trust anyone, Bali Amana have been lost, and it sounds quite depressing. Now, there's obviously an important intent that the Mishnah Chazal is teaching us here. Even the end of the Masecha says that Shmuel, HaKotan, and Hillel HaZaken should have had Ruach HaKodesh, but because of the generation, they didn't. So what does Chazal want to tell us here? What's the chizik? And it ends up by saying, Ela Einan Lishon Ela Avinu Shabashamayim. So I think the lesson, and also the Tosefta ends off with the following. It says, Kolam Yisabel Yisholayim Zoycha Roev Zoycha V'simchasa. So there's a famous Chassam Sefer. He says, why does it say someone that mourns Yerushalayim is Zoycha V'roi V'simcha? It says Yiske. Yiske means it will. Says the Chassam Sefer, an incredible lesson, that when a person is really paying attention to what it was, what Yerushalayim was, it's not the Yiske you'll be able to see in the future, what Yerushalayim, the Yisimcha. You could start feeling it even now. So I was thinking that the chizuk, although yeah, it is sad that we're in a generation with such darkness, but at the same time, the darkness, when a person appreciates what it was, then you can start tasting even some of it now. And I think that's why the Chazal end up by saying, it means that on the one hand, and we just learned this actually today in Chavis HaLevavos, in Shaul Bitochen, he discusses the idea that sometimes a person is lonely, doesn't have any family, doesn't have any kids. So from the Pchina Bitochen, the Chavis HaLevavos says, a person also could look at it as now is a time where I could actually focus on myself and my relationship with the Rabbanu Shel Olam. That's what Chavis HaLevavos says. A person has to know that whatever situation he's in is the best thing for him. So even with all his darkness, it gives us an opportunity to strengthen our relationship with the Rabbanu Shel Olam.